This is a Honeywell model HS-300, made in 2006. This is actually a bit of a childhood fan. My grandmother originally had one of these, except it was the 18-inch version, and it actually had the metal cross base rather than this rounded base here. Yeah, she originally bought it from Wegmans. Of course, it was barely used due to how loud it is, which seems to be a very common theme with these rectangular Honeywell fans from this time frame. Anyways, that fan she had until 2009. Basically what happened is that the base was becoming cracked and it was still able to sit into the base, but it was just loose. And while we were cleaning it out, my mom was like, it has to go, all because of that cracked base. Yeah. I mentioned this on Facebook, but my parents were very quick to throw things out for minor flaws when some of them could have easily been fixed, but hey, as they say, hindsight's 20/20. Anyway, this fan I got from eBay, it has not been in the best condition. Originally, the blade cap was cracked and was being held together by some, I want to say gum, but I don't know what it truly was. The cap for the cage was also stripped out. Like, I actually had to get a blade nut from a Duracraft fan that eventually burnt out. Yeah, it's hard to see, but you might have noticed that that's a little beat up. Also got a bit of paint, as well as some yellowing. So yeah, this fan has seen some better days, but at least it still works. From what I understand, these fans are becoming harder to find. I wonder if it's largely because that they're becoming seized up. Like, I actually had another HS-300 before this one that was becoming seized up. Unfortunately, the screws were completely jacked up and I couldn't open it properly, so I just said, you know what, screw it. I just realized I made an unintentional pun there. Anyway, the control pad was also becoming warm on that fan, so it wasn't just a case of the motor being seized up, it was also the electronics, for whatever reason, were warming up. This one does not seem to have that problem. I also know that there's a version with automatic oscillation, which Jordan Yu has. Personally, I think the automatic oscillation is kind of a dumb idea, since it's just one more thing to break. It's one thing for tower fans, but when you can easily just put a gearbox and attach it to the motor. But then again, I guess some people like the idea of being able to turn the oscillation on and off with just a press of a remote. This one does not have the remote. I tried ordering one from eBay, but it wouldn't work, so we're just having to use the touchpad. Anyways, let's actually get it away from the windstream. It starts off on low. Yeah, like I said, these Honeywell fans were very loud. Yeah, motor doesn't sound too great either. The medium. And high. It actually blows a decent breeze, but like I said, it's just loud. Let's turn it back to low. And we'll have it oscillate. oscillates with no problem. It also has this stupid breeze function that I've seen on a lot of other remote control fans, which apparently the idea is to simulate natural wind outside, but that one, the sound of the fan kind of ruins that, and two, I'm pretty sure that will just wear out the motor faster doing that. Also has a timer. It has 2 hours, 4 hours, and 8 hours. Let's go back to high. And off. Spin down is not the greatest. I don't know if that's because the motor needs oil or it's just the blades. But yeah, like I said, this isn't the greatest thing, but the fact it still works, it still blows a decent breeze, and compared to some of the other fans I've seen from the 2000s, it's a bit more durable. Like Honeywell still used a lot of the Duracraft parts around this time, so their fans still had some sort of decent build before they, like I know later versions of the fans had plastic grills. Anyways, I'll see you guys later. She had died.